Squad, it's your boy Cedric, and today I'm announcing that I now have Grits Squad merch. So go ahead and check out my shop, purchase a shirt or a jacket or any other items that you would like. Peace. Consider supporting Eat My Grits ASMR on Patreon for just $1 a month. Link below in the description. Yo, what's up, Grit Squad? It's Cedric, and today I'm about to do a story time. And I don't remember if it was 8th grade or 7th grade, but I remember the principal I went to, and I believe she was the 6th and 7th grade principal. Like, something was weird about my middle school. I didn't understand how they did it. I don't know. But, like, we had the main principal, and, of course, assistant principals, but, like, they were over, like, one was over just 8th grade, and one was over 6th grade and 7th grade. And, you know, you had the main principal over all the school. I don't know. I didn't necessarily get it. I hope y'all don't hear that music outside, because I got my headphones in and I can hear it through this Blue Yeti. You can really hear everything. But anyway, what I was about to say. So yeah, I don't remember if it was 8th grade or 7th grade, but I do remember going to the 7th grade principal. Trying to figure this out. I don't necessarily remember, but anyway, you know, it was basically a very, very normal day at school. You know, did some school work, yada yada, chopped it up with friends, PE, all that good stuff. And so it was time to go home. Now, I don't know why my school district was like that, but I didn't go to school in the ghetto for some reason. Like, if you go, it's not that far. You can walk the distance to, like, a corner store, right? And across the street, that district had to, that little area had to go to school in the hood. And then across the street on my district, we went to school in this predominantly white neighborhood. So, it was a bunch of, it wasn't really the suburbs, but like the suburbs, but there was a bunch of those ghetto kids and suburban kids kind of mixed in together, I would say, something like that. And, you know, a lot of clashes. I got into a fight with this kid, this white kid, over something. We're not going to talk about that because your boy Cedric is peace with their hands. But anyway, so it was time to go home this day, and we're getting on the bus, and, you know, I don't know what happened between, it was this guy, we're just gonna call him Phil. He's like gay, and then it was my little brother's girlfriend at the time. Well, they might, I don't know, they still be messing with each other to this day, even though the girl is married, but she still misses my brother. That's why I don't trust these, I don't trust the hoes. Told y'all I don't be friends with none of them, because I don't trust them. But you know, I love my girlfriend. but y'all get what I'm trying to say though, man. Look, females be shiesty, and then they'll try to make it seem like you did something when it's just them and their emotions. But anyway, we're on a bus, and I'm sorry that this is everywhere, because it's not a really, really long story. I'm just trying to drag it out to meet the YouTube goal thing of trying to get at least freaking 10 minutes, because if you don't get 10 minutes, then, you know, YouTube tries to handle you with your payments, and they don't try to push your videos, and they already admitted that when you subscribe, they don't push out the content, so you may thank you. But it was this gay guy named Phil and my brother's girlfriend at the time, my little brother's girlfriend at the time, they got into it on the bus, and for a little ways they was just arguing and arguing and yelling and yelling. And what ended up happening was the bus driver, she stopped the bus a few times, but she didn't call the police those first few times. She just stopped the bus and said, "Y'all stop it." She was a real sweet lady. She used to give out like the little crackers and stuff, and you know, one of them Christian ladies, y'all know I ain't with all that, but she was cool. And so yeah, she stopped the bus a few times, and I'm sorry, I'm getting sidetracked, y'all. I hear a motorcycle on some outside, and it's annoying me when I'm trying to do this. But anyway, she stopped the bus a few times, but she never like called the police. So what happened was we ended up getting in the neighborhood that I used to live in. And then she like, cause we just passed the police station, okay? And all you got to do is go down. Then it's one, two lights after the police station. So when she hit that second light, they were still arguing. She just pulled the bus over to this gas station. It's still there, too. She pulled over to the gas station, and then she called the police, okay? And like, they were still arguing and everything, and then like, I know they was about to start fighting, but my little sister, my little sister jumped in between them to try to get them to stop from fighting, because my little sister didn't want to see her friend fighting. Like, they were both her friends, so she didn't want to see them fighting. And so by that time, my sister was standing up trying not to have them fight. The cop had already made it there, and he was boarding the bus, and it was her, my sister, and the gay dude. They were like going back to what my sister was like still standing up. What happened was like her seat, her book bag and stuff was in the back way of the bus. So the gay dude, Phil, and my brother's ex-girlfriend were both like at the front of the bus. So as the cops walking on, they sit down and my sister starts to walk back towards her seat. But when the cop get on the bus, he just says, "Hey, you come here," like that. And so he takes my sister off of the bus, and I'm just sitting, and then I get up and I go to the other side of the bus where he's taking my sister to look and see what's going on. And I see him putting handcuffs on my sister. So that's when I just blanked out, man. I like stormed, like I ran off of the bus, and like I was screaming like, "What the you doing, bro? She ain't douche," and all that stuff and everything. And you know, I know some little white dude's gonna be in the comment section like, "He should have fucking shot you, you nigger." I already know that's coming. But fuck y'all. crack ass crackers are gonna say that. Not the white people, but the crack ass crackers are gonna say some dumb shit like that. But anyway, like what happened was I tried to rush him and slam him, and so in the midst of that, he didn't like try to hurt me or slam me or anything. Like, I grabbed him and I was trying to pick him up like he's a big heavy cop, but I'm doing everything I can to try and slam this cop. Like, I'm really trying to slam this cop and everything, and we start tussling and bustling and everything for about, I'd say, every bit of like 4 or 5 minutes. And then he finally got the best of me, and so I don't know how, but he finally got behind me and grabbed me and had, you know, had me like that. And what he did was, when he got me like that, he leaned forward, put his body weight on me, and I was on the back of his squad car, and so he had his body weight on me on the back of his squad car, and I was just wrestling, trying to get away from him. please stop. Just let them handcuff you. Please, please stop. And so then I just stopped and I calmed down a little bit and he handcuffed me. And that's when he unhandcuffed my sister, made her get on the bus, and then they drove the bus away. And then he took me, put me in the back seat. That was the first time I was in the back of a police car. I think that was the first and only time I was ever in a police car. I believe so. My bad, child. I gotta get used to this microphone. I gotta get used to this Blue Yeti, cause like I'm listening to myself. I never did this before. But yeah. And so I'm in the back seat, and he drives me to the police station, and I'm in like his little office room. He's asking me questions, my name, do I have any tattoos, nicknames, and all that good stuff. And so, like, but he didn't do fingerprints, so he wasn't booking me or anything. So I just like, he was sitting in, say for instance, like I'm looking at y'all, he has a chair that's facing back this way, so I'm sitting in the chair facing back that way, and he's doing other paperwork then, and he's like, call your mom or grandma or something. Like, I was kind of nervous. I remember saying, he was like, call, okay, you call. And I was like, Liberta or something, but my grandma's name is Rose, and like, call Rose, her real name's Liberta. I kept saying Roberta, he called Rose. I don't know, I was nervous, but he called my grandma. And like, all of my family goes to my grandma, so all of my people were there. They heard, he was like, y'all come pick him up. So my parents, they weren't around. They were actually in my grandma's area, but not where my grandma was. So what happened was, it's Tallmanville, then Thomasville. Thomasville is way far away. And when I talked to my people and stuff, I was telling them that they're on their way from Tallmanville, and I guess he thought I said Thomasville, like Thomasville's like hours away. He was like, well, if they don't show up at some time, he's like, just gonna have to take you to the youth center. But what happened was, my stepdad eventually came before the time that he needed to take him to the youth center and all that stuff. And my stepdad looked at him like, whoa, he said something that referenced me and the cop wrestling each other, because the cop had took it off his uniform. He just had on like a white t-shirt, but it was kind of dirty from his squad car and us, you know, wrestling and stuff. And that's really it, and nothing else happened. No Okay, well, that was that, you know. I didn't get any real trouble for that. But I remember going back to school. That's what I'm saying. I remember talking to the 7th grade principal. And I don't know, something probably happened that they made her the 8th grade principal, because somebody probably left. But this is so long. This is middle school, y'all. I'm 26. This is so long ago. It's like 14, 15, stuff like that. But anyway, I was talking to her, and she was like, she said, you had a fight with the cop. She's like, you had a fight with the cop, right? And she was like, yeah. And I was like, okay. And then she said, like, she was happy that I did it, but then, you know, she was kind of scared at the same time, because she was like, yeah. And then she's like, don't be stupid no more like that, because she was happy that I wrestled the cop. She was happy that I wrestled the cop and stuff. And she was like, because I didn't punch him, she was like, did you get him good? And I was like, I guess so. We ain't really fight, we just, you know, wrestled, like, tussled. She was like, good, something like that. She was like, don't be stupid no more. They got guns, they can kill you. Oh man, I remember that principal, because she actually used to come to our hood and buy coke. That's why I remember her so well. She bought coke from my cousins. So yeah, but that was it. I think I got suspended from riding the bus or something like that, but it's cool. But that's what happened, y'all. That's what I wrestled the cop. And I'm trying to figure out, was it 7th or 8th grade because of that principal? But it's so long ago. But anyway, thanks for watching.